अनंत कान्हेरे। आफ्टर 1857 देर वॉज अ स्ट्रिक्ट रिस्ट्रिक्शन लेड डाउन ऑन कीपिंग आर्म्स एंड वेपन्स। स्वातंत्र्यवीर सावरकर हैड ऑर्डर्ड जर्मन ब्रूम हैंडल रिवॉल्वर्स फ्रॉम बैरिस्टर राणा इन पैरिस। बॉक्सेस वर मेड विथ फॉल्स बेस टू हाइड द पिस्टल्स। इवन द बुक्स वर कार्व्ड फ्रॉम इनसाइड टू हाइड द पिस्टल्स and pass them to all the freedom fighters all over the country. 20 such pistols were sent through Chaturbhuj Amin to Mumbai. They were distributed in Nasik at different places, but the greedy Amin retained one with him. The same pistol proved fatal to ruin himself and Savarkar. Savarkar brothers had created great commotion among the youngsters of Nasik. They were provoked with patriotism. To remove such treacherous acts, Pandit Jackson, ICS, was sent by the British government to be the collector of Nasik. He knew Sanskrit and Marathi very well. He loved to see Marathi plays. He disliked social reformers and especially those who struggled for the freedom. He stopped the procession taken out against the color and race differences, putting many such reformers in jail. He had harassed many youngsters, charging them with some or the other offense because they shouted the slogan of Vande Mataram in a Dasera procession on 26 September 1906. There was a protest march when Lokmanya Tilak was given life imprisonment. He tried to desolate the march. Many were severely punished. Without any strong proof, the four poems written by Baba Rao Savarkar were claimed as written against the British government, and he was sentenced for life imprisonment and sent to Andaman. During the trial period, he was publicly humiliated in the city of Nasik. Savarkar family's all property was seized. The humiliation of Baba Rao Savarkar was the last straw on the camel's back. Members of Abhinav Bharat decided to take revenge. A young lad from Aurangabad named Anant Lakshman Kanhere worshipped Savarkar like God. He was in contact with the members of Abhinav Bharat. He showed his readiness to kill Jackson. Jackson was promoted as a commissioner in 1909 for successfully removing all the activities of the freedom fighters. He had to move to some different place in the coming year. The revolutionists decided that they won't allow Jackson to be alive till then. The honored people in Nasik decided to put him off with the help of Kirloskar Theatre Group. They were famous for the dramas. Company organized a play named Sharda. Bal Gandharva was playing the role of Sharda. It was planned that they would kill Jackson in the same program. Vinayak Rao Deshpande personally went to Aurangabad and got Anant Kanheri to Nasik. He came to Deshpande's residence, who gave him two automated broom handle revolvers loaded with the bullets. These revolvers were the same which Savarkar had sent through the hands of Chaturbhuj Amin. As a result, he got caught in the Nasik plot. Along with that, they provided Anant Kanheri with a heading, "Murder for a murder, attack for the violence." Thinking of his young age, they felt he would be in no position to give any explanation for Jackson's murder. So once the job was done, he was advised to eat the poison powder. On 21st December 1909, Anant Kanhere moved out to reach Vijayanand Theatre at night. One of the revolvers was hidden in the plates of his dhoti near the stomach, and the second one, which was chrome-plated, was placed in his left coat pocket. In the right pocket, he had the packet of poison powder. He reached the theater without wearing a cap and sat near the door platform, positioning himself well. Jackson arrived late for the program. He entered when the second scene of the first act was on. Song was on the scene. Jackson was accompanied by another British ICS officer by the name Jolly and a few British women. As he was moving down the steps, looking at the play and chatting with the ladies, Anant got down from the platform. he removed the revolver from his plates and in a moment shot the bullet in Jackson's back. The bullet passed under his arm without hurting him. Before anyone could even register that, he came in front and shot 5 bullets in his chest, one after the other. His chest was perforated like a sieve all over the place, and he died surrounded by the pool of blood. Jolly leaped on Anand and pulled him back, holding his hand with the revolver. The same moment, Superintendent of Police Todarmal came rushing there. He pulled the revolver from Anand's hand, which was still fuming with smoke. Mamledar Palshikar of Yevle hit him hard with a stick on his head. He was taken to the police office and questioned for his statement till 2 o'clock in the night. The very same night, they started inquiring regarding the houses and arresting people. 50 such youngsters were put behind bars. With unbearable torture, they went on giving their statements to the police. When these raids were on, the police held Chaturbhuj Amin, who was moving around in a suspicious manner. When they checked him, they got the Browning revolver from him. He was immediately arrested. When he was strictly questioned, he went on telling everything, including the name of Savarkar. Later, he turned approver. That is, he became the volatile police witness in the Nasik court. His witness was vital in sending Savarkar to Andaman for his punishment. On 6 January 1910, the case was put up in the rooms of a government bungalow, which was temporarily converted into a courtroom. After the first hearing, with writing statements, Magistrate Montgomery had the second hearing session on 1st Feb 1910. According to the new law, Jackson murder case of 1908 was to be conducted at Bombay High Court. According to this new law, no justices were allowed and no permission was granted to make any appeal on the court decision. All convicts were taken to the Baikala jail. Anant Kanhere, Anna Karve, Vinayak Rao Deshpande, Shankar Rao Soman, Vaman Rao Joshi, Ganu Vaidya and Dattu Joshi were the convicts in the Jackson case, and the hearing took place at Bombay High Court. The Chief Justice was Sir Wessel Scott, while the others were Narayan Chandavarkar and Hilton. The case hearing began from 7th March 1910. Anand Kanhere took all the responsibility on his shoulder and went courageously to face the case. On 30th March 1910, the Chief Justice Sir Scott himself read the verdict. Anand Kanhere and Vinayak Rao Joshi were to be hanged, and Shankar Rao Soman and Vaman Rao Joshi were given life imprisonment. Ganu Vaidya was also sentenced for life imprisonment, and Dattu Joshi had to undergo rigorous imprisonment for 2 years. Ganu Vaidya and Dattu Joshi became the excuse police witness in the case against Savarkar at Nasik, so the punishment was not enforced on them. All the convicts were immediately shifted to the Thane jail. On 19th April 1910, 7 o'clock in the morning, Kanhere, Karve and Deshpande were hanged in Thane jail. All the three faced their death courageously and with a smile on their face.